Hello and welcome you in the course of Probability and Statistics. I am your instructor Hardik Joshi. Now in this lecture we should start one new concept in the probability and statistics, namely correlations. Now these are very useful and important topic in this particular course. So let's start. What is correlations? So remember, the word itself suggests that correlation. So the word itself suggests that if we have to study the relation between say particular two random experiment or two random variable, which type of relation is exist among the variable x as well as among the variable y, to study the relation between these two random variable is known as the correlations. Remember, these are the one of the example. In the context of this course, we have to consider the random variable x and random variable y. How the one variable x behave with respect to second variable y? If the value of one variable is increase, what is the changes occurs in the second variable y when the first variable increase? When the variable is decrease, what is its effects on the second variable? So in general, we conclude that to study the relation among the two variable is known as the correlations. If you have to talk about a simple example in our day-to-day life, if we have to talk about say two friends, not friends, say two person. If we have to talk about say two person and we have to see which type of relation is exists among these two person, to study this type of relationship is known as the study of correlations. If that two persons are friends, so definitely if the one person say come across say one decision, say it may be anything, let's move from say visits say particular park, then in the decision of the first friend, second friend say okay, I am with you, let's go to visit the park. That is, whatever decision taken by the first friend, the second friend, because he's a friend, second friend gives its positive inputs to visit the park. So there are say positive relations exist. If we have to talk about say enemy, say if two persons are even don't talk with each other, I don't know what is the reason behind that, I have to give the just example. If the two person has not talk with each other, whatever something events occurs in the past, but due to that events they are not talk with each other. And if the first person suggests that say this particular phone is a very good, I know the features of this particular phone, and we know that the second person which are in against of that, so definitely his decision or his thoughts is in against of that person's. No, I don't like the features of this particular phone. Now it's a very rubbish. So this type of behavior is just like opposites. If the one person just like say yes, these are very good quantity, the second one says that no, it's a very worse quantity. So these are the opposites. Yeah, we have to say that the negative correlations. Yeah, if we have to talk about say two particular person, So one person is from Ahmedabad city, and the second person is say any of the say we have to consider say Rajkot city, and we have to assume that that two persons even do not know each other, they do not meet in the past. So that means they do not know each other. So definitely whatever decision taken by the first person, it doesn't affect the decision on the second person, because they even don't know each other. It doesn't matter what is the done or happening by the first person or what is doing by the second person. The activity performed by that two person is independent. So this type of behavior among these two people, two person, is known as the independent. We have to say that there is no correlations. So let's see, when we have to deal with the real life example, how we can calculate. So whatever thing I have to explain you, we have to write down here. Correlation is nothing, it's just a study of relation between two variables. The data can be represented by the order pair x and y. Out of this, one of the variable is independent and second one is depends on the other, or vice versa. Either you have to assume x is independent, y is dependent, or vice versa, it doesn't matter. So when you have to calculate the, or you have to deal with the real life data, that is we have to find out the correlation among two variable x and y. So remember the first thing, the correlation is denoted by say small number r. So small r represents the value of the correlation, and correlation is always lying between minus 1 and plus 1. And the value of this r is represents the strength of the relation among two variables. So if the value of r is positive 1, then we have to say that there is a strong positive correlation between two random variables x and y. If the value of this r is negative 1, then there is a strong negative correlations, that is strong negative correlations, or in precise word, when value of r is minus 1 or plus 1, we have to say that is a perfect correlation, whether it is positive or negative, but is a perfect correlations. When the value of r is 0, that is the midpoint of this interval minus 1 to 1, so we have to say that there is no relation among these two people, even though they, because they do not know each other. If the one is happy, it doesn't affect the second person, because you know they do not know that person. If they are sad, then again it doesn't affect the second person, because they do not know each other. That's why when r is equal to 0, there is no relation between two random variable x and y. When the value of r is a positive 0.25, we say that there is a weak positive correlations between two random variable x and y. Same thing, when r is a negative 0.25, we say that there is a weak negative correlation between two random variable x and y. When r is lies or falls within the interval positive 0.25 to positive 0.75, we conclude that there is intermediate positive correlation. Same thing, when r fall within the interval negative 25 to negative 0.75, we said that there is an intermediate negative correlations among two random variable x and y. When r is greater than 0.75, we have to say that there is strong positive correlations. When r is less than negative 0.75, we conclude that there is strong negative correlations between two random variable x and y. So whenever you have to deal with the find out the correlation coefficients r, so it's first step or very basic step to prepare this particular chart. because whenever you have to calculate the coefficients are, and you have to interpret your results, you have to require the value of this chart. So next thing we have to see that how we can calculate the value of R. This slide suggests once we have to get the value of R, then we have to interpret our results. But the question is still arises, how we can calculate the value of R. So let's next see how we can obtain the value of correlation coefficients R. Yeah, simultaneously we have to see the example and we have to see that how we can obtain the value of coefficient correlation R. So let's deal with the example. The question suggests that a sample of 6 children was selected. Data about their age in year, that is age is given in the year, and weight, the weight of the students definitely is given in the kg, kilogram, was recorded in this particular table. And now the data is a collection of 6 children, that is first children, second, third, and so on, 6 children. So we have to interpret as randomly we have to select the first children whose age is 7 year and whose weight is 12 kg. Similarly, the age of the second student is 6 year and his weight is 8 kg. Respectively, the age and weight of 6 students is 9 and 13 respectively. What we have to done? We are interested to find out the correlation between age and weight of the students. Remember, we have to conclude say one of the relation between the age of the students and weight of the students. Remember, if you have to talk about say, any of the city, any particular college, any particular town, and we have to study the relation between weight and height, then it becomes very much difficult. So here we have to consider the very simple example where our size of the data is very restricted. The size of the data is just a collection of 6 children. So we have to see the concept by taking the very simple example, but the same concept we have to enlarge for the large sample. So let's move to calculate, to study the relation between, which type of relation between exist among age and weight of the children. So we have to define some of the strategy. So here we have to consider age as our one variable, say x, and y is our second variable, this is represented by weight. Because ultimately when you have to dealing with the say data, so you have to assume this physical abstraction in terms of the mathematical quantity. So we have to assume say x, that is age, as a random variable x, and weight as a random variable y. We have to randomly assume say age is independent. So definitely the second data is depends on the age of the children, so second variable is dependent. Our aim is we have to study the relation between age and weights. So Carl Pearson is one of the greatest statistician in early century. They have to derive one of the major important formulations. So namely, correlation coefficients is denoted by R, and is obtain these coefficients in terms of the statistical parameter. The correlation coefficient can be obtained with the help of this sum of xy, sum of x, sum of y, and that is total number of observations. So to deal or to find out this relation among these two variables, we have to require the knowledge of say sum of x, sum of y, and sum of xy. If we have to know this quantity, then we have to easily predict which type of relation is exist among two variables x and y. So as a student point of view, you have to remember this formula of correlation given by Carl Pearson. So for sake of simplicity, we have to write down all the data which is given in the definition in the form of table. So this first, second and third column we have to carry forward as it is, which is given in the definition. Next we have to calculate this x square y square. XY is nothing, just a multiplication of these two. So 7 into 12 84, 6 into 8 48, 8 into 12 96, so on, 39 are, so 170. Now x square, that is just nothing, just a square of this particular second column. So 7 square 49, 6 square 36, and so on, 9 square 81. Similarly, we have to obtain the square of this particular random variable y, and we have to write down in the last column. So we have to find out the sum of each and every column, that is 7 plus 6, that is 13 plus 8 21, plus 5 26, plus 6 32 32 plus 9 41. So sum of x is 41. Similarly, we have to find out sum of each of this particular four column, and we have to come across sum of y is 66, sum of xy is 461, sum of x square and sum of y square is 291, 742 respectively. So just we have to plug in the value of sum of x, sum of x square, sum of xy, sum of x square and sum of y square, and n is 6 in this particular correlation coefficients given by the Carl Pearson. So we have to arrive at this stage. So by solving this, we have to get the value of r is 0.759. so we know that the value of r is a positive 0.75, it definitely is greater than 0.75. so we come across there is a strong positive correlation between age and weight of the children. Why strong positive? Because the value of correlation coefficients is greater than 0.75, and we know that if the value of r is among between 0.75 to 1, then there is strong positive correlation between two variables x and y. So thank you so much for paying your attention.